1 minute. Summation, Mr. Horton, 1 minute.
Thank you. I hope this forum has given you an idea about what each of us stands for. I believe I'm the best candidate for post 3 because my agenda is your agenda. I've been successful in business for over 30 years, and I understand the private sector as well as city government. I've served my community in everything from HOAs to arts to housing development, and I will serve the Roswell citizens because some of our city council aren't doing that very well. Most of you tell me you don't want to live in an urban center where the downtown buildings come right to the street, and the houses are crammed together, and there's little green space on city lots. You tell me you want to fix the blight and put higher density where it makes sense, not around our established neighborhoods. You say the city council needs to address traffic and infrastructure. And you tell me your government isn't listening to you. I think that means we need a change, and the time to make it is now. The mayor and some council members are pulling for one of my opponents because he's been part of their club for years. It's time for you to be heard, and if you honor me with your vote, I'll make sure someone listens to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
1 minute, Mr. Gray.
Well, I just wanted to thank everybody for coming this evening. And you know, one thing that's unique about Post 3 is I'm not running against these gentlemen up here. I'm running for Post 3. I have no idea how these gentlemen will vote, but I do know how I will vote. I will vote for my wife, for myself, for you, and for my children. That hopefully will come in at some point. I will say this. When I look down at the list of things that I absolutely want you to know about me, number one, I think I can sit up here and say that I'm the only 100% self-funded candidate. I will not accept one penny of money and have turned money down. Every penny that I've spent on my campaign has come out of my wife and my personal bank account. I'm doing it because I believe in Roswell. Roswell is a part of who I am. It is a part of my DNA. I am here sitting before you to tell you that my goal, my job, 100% from day one, is 100% working on the density that equals the traffic that equals the density. They go hand in hand. I'm not going to stop until we rectify both. Thank you.
Mr. Swenson.
I have an unprecedented knowledge of this amazing city and what makes it so special. It's absolutely imperative that someone with my experience and love for the citizens and the community be elected on November 3rd. We are experiencing tremendous opportunities of economic growth, which brings us to an important crossroads that requires skill, experience, and proven leadership. We must wisely take advantage of these opportunities while also being careful to protect our quality of life that we love. I will continue to serve and protect you as I have for so many years by listening and making wise, meaningful, well-thought-out, sustainable, and sometimes very tough decisions. I would appreciate your vote, and we'll be honored that you did vote for Ricky Spencer. And the other night, I was labeled as a good old boy and a City Hall insider, and tonight I'm in a club. Mr. Horton, I appreciate the compliments. Thank you very much.
Mr. Horton.
I'm invested in this city. And when I say I'm invested in this city, I don't just mean I own a house here. I own two businesses here. My wife and I each own one. Located in Roswell. I employ 8 people right here in Roswell, 5 of which actually live here. So when I'm talking about the taxes that go to GM, that's money that I don't get to invest in my own business. That's money that local business owners don't get to invest in their own businesses. That money comes from somewhere. And it's taken from the local business owners. And it's given, and the residents too. Thank you for your comments. But it's given to other businesses, incentivizing them to come here. But my established business that's been here, that's employing people here, doesn't get that. Maybe if I moved it to the other side of Roswell, I might get a little special incentive because that's an incentive area, but that's not good for my business. I'm invested in this city above and beyond a lot of the people on this stage because I want to see this city grow, and I want to see it grow not just in population, but I want to see the businesses in this area grow, and I want to see them thrive as well.
Well,
thank you, Mr. Hurd. I want to thank the Women's Club again tonight for hosting and for y'all taking time out on your Wednesday night to come sit here and listen to us jabber for 2 hours. Roswell is a great place to live, work, and raise families, and I think that you can see that that's been the theme from all of the candidates in this race. The city is fiscally sound, services continue to improve, and our millage rate has not increased. These don't happen by accident, guys. They are the results of strong leadership and the vision of the elected mayor and city council. Our city is a model for Metro Atlanta and throughout the state. And to achieve this, we have had to make difficult decisions, taking into account protecting the interests of our neighborhoods, yes I do, improving infrastructure and allowing development in appropriate areas. The city cannot stop landowners from asking for rezoning, but we can manage and continue and condition their requests so we can preserve our Roswell's character. If we're elected, I will continue to listen to you and serve as your neighborhood advocate and as your voice on city council, and I would appreciate your vote on November 3rd. Thank you.
Mr. Palermo.
So luckily for me, I was looking at the audience, and about half of the people here are already supporters of mine, which I really appreciate. I want to apologize. I'm actually going to address the other half that I haven't spoken with yet. I have a big request for you. Please, when you're thinking about on November 3rd who you want to vote for, please do not just make the decision based off of this one evening. What I really ask you is, please, on my flyers outside, I have my phone number, I have my email, please reach out to me, please speak with me. This is why I have such a great base of support, even though I just met them really during this campaign. I really am asking you that instead of just looking at just this evening and really making a decision on who you want to serve you for the next 4 years, please, in addition to speaking with me, please look at really what's happened in really the last 4 years, last 8 years. Please decide and look to yourself if you really love what you see in parts of Holcomb Bridge and Highway 9, if you love what's happened around Goulding Place, or the fact that Dolphin House at any time can be built with 5 houses around there right now today, or if you like that much higher density of all townhouses everywhere. So please speak with me. I appreciate your time today.
Thank you. Mr. DeBlito.
Thank you. Mr. Gray, I certainly hope that when you have a child with the birth announcements in the newspaper.
No charge.
Thank you. I'm going to hold you to that.
Once again, I'd like to thank the Roswell Women's Club for hosting this event, and I'd like to thank Mr. Hurd for being a wonderful moderator tonight. Thank you so much. I started off tonight talking about quality of life, and quality of life doesn't just happen. It's something that you have to plan for. And we need to plan for a good foundation. And part of that is that we need to strengthen our local economy, we need to promote redevelopment, we need to improve transportation. Those are things we talked a little bit about here tonight, and they're all way too big topics to try to cover in such a short period of time. But I talk a lot about it on my website, so if you go to richforroswell.com, there's plenty of information in there that tells you about my perspective on all that, and I'd love for you to take a look at it. It's been an honor and a pleasure serving each and every one of you. I hope that I have the opportunity to continue that. I look forward to serving you and also protecting and enhancing our quality of life. I appreciate your vote on November 3rd. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Mr. Zapata.
I want to thank the Roswell Women Club for organizing a great event for all my neighbors from Roswell. I've lived in Roswell for the last 15 years. I have a small business company. I'm running for Roswell City Council because I'm concerned about the future development and growth of our historical and charming city. I will bring to the City Council a new approach and perspective regarding the analysis and decision process. It's going to be based from the resident perspective and sustained by solid data and not by subjective personal interests full of assumptions and generalizations. I can give you some good example of my approach. I will promote infrastructure first before approving any new high density development. I will invest in traffic flow first before spending $500,000 on decorating a bridge on top of 400 with public art. And I will make sure the city council communicate with the neighbors and does a better job in engaging the residents. It is time to reboot the city council, and the place is to start by voting for me on November 3rd. Thank you again for this opportunity.
Now, if all of you will please stand up. Ladies and gentlemen, these people back here are why the American system works in Roswell. They make the system work. They give you some choices. got a lot of decisions to make, but I'd like you to think them all now.
Thank you.